Good morning, everyone, and welcome to our second community prayer virtually. I'd like to point out, and I realized I didn't in our last community prayer, that I'm in our chapel in the mansion. And if you're ever feeling like you need a pause during your day and you just need to have some quiet time and connect with God, the chapel's a great place to stop by. Part of the mission of our school is to inspire our students to live the prophetic nature of the gospel. Prophets are people who speak the word of God, and often in the Bible, they were telling hard truths. To view the gospel as prophetic means to view it as full of truths for us to apply to our lives today. The gospel values can be applied to our world. This morning, we'll hear from Isabel Oliver, one of our student ministers, as well as Dr. Willis. They'll both be speaking about applying the gospel to our lives. The Sisters of Notre Dame, in their constitutions, wrote that we have a responsibility to shape our lives according to gospel values. When we reflect on gospel passages, we are called to think about their message, to analyze it, and to apply it to our lives.
Hi everyone, my name is Isabel Oliver, and I'm the student minister for social justice. I know it's been a little overwhelming coming back to school and everything, but I hope things have settled down for you at this point. We haven't seen each other in a really long time, and because of that, I want us to acknowledge a prominent issue that has come to light since then. There have been many incidents of social unrest that call for our voices to be heard and for us to continue to play an active role in combating systemic racism. Since the murder of George Floyd on May 25th, there have been an alarming number of Black Americans killed by the police. These unjust killings shed light on the heightened realities of police brutality and racism in our country. We as a country and we as a school community have a lot of work to do. But for right now, I want us to come together and pray to realize the extent of racism in our country and to have the courage to practice anti-racism. Our community prayer today calls us to reflect on the parable of the Good Samaritan. We are called to go and do likewise, and to be neighbors to everyone we meet. Our work to grow in anti-racism is part of being neighbors and being women of Notre Dame. Let us pray. Dear God, in the effort to dismantle racism, I understand that I struggle not merely against flesh and blood, but against powers and principalities, those institutions and systems that keep racism alive by perpetuating the lie that some members of our family are inferior and others superior. Create in me a new mind and heart that will enable me to see my brothers and sisters in the faces of those divided by racial categories. Give me the grace and strength to rid myself of racial stereotypes that oppress some in my family while providing entitlements to others. Help me to create a nation that embraces the hopes and fears of oppressed people of color where we live, as well as those around the world. Help me to heal your family, making me one with you and empowered by your Holy Spirit. Amen.
A reading from the Gospel of Luke. There was a scholar of the law who stood up to test him and said, "Teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" Jesus said to him, "What is written in the law? How do you read it?" He said in reply, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your being, with all your strength, and with all your mind, and your neighbor as yourself." He replied to him, "You have answered correctly. Do this and you will live." But because he wished to justify himself, he said to Jesus, "And who is my neighbor?" Jesus replied, "A man fell victim to robbers as he went down to Jerusalem to Jericho. They stripped and beat him and went off, leaving him half dead. A priest happened to be going down that road, but when he saw him, he passed by on the opposite side. Likewise, a Levite came to the place, and when he saw him, he passed by on the opposite side. But a Samaritan traveler who came upon him was moved with compassion at the sight. He approached the victim, poured oil and wine over his wounds, and bandaged him. Then he lifted up on his own animal, took him to an inn, and cared for him. The next day, he took out 2 silver coins and gave them to the innkeeper with the instruction, 'Take care of him. If you spend more than what I have given you, I shall repay you on my way back. Which of these three, in your opinion, was neighbor to the robber's victim? He answered, the one who treated him with mercy. Jesus said to him, go and do likewise. The Gospel of the Lord.
Good morning, everyone. Happy Wednesday. I hope you're all doing well. Thank you, Ms. Tully, for inviting me to reflect with you on the parable of the Good Samaritan. This reading comes to us from the Gospel of Luke, and as we know, Luke has the audience of the underdog, and so it's no surprise that we hear this powerful teaching from Jesus asking us to think about the story of the man abandoned on the side of the road, in dire straits, needing help and being refused by others, only to be served and cared for by someone outside of his community. There are so many wise, powerful individuals who have reflected upon the parable of the Good Samaritan, and one of them being Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., who says at various times in our lives, we see ourselves as different characters in the story. Sometimes we are the person abandoned and harmed and in danger on the side of the road, feeling like others aren't paying attention to us, feeling that we are hurt and in need and not getting those needs met. Sometimes we are those walking by that individual. Sometimes we are refusing to share our gifts or our ability to be of service to others in need. And sometimes we're the Good Samaritan. Sometimes we are taking advantage of that opportunity to help others and to give of ourselves and to give our gifts. And it's important that we recognize that we have different moments of connection across our lives with these different aspects of the story. Another person who's reflected powerfully on this parable is Father James Martin, SJ. He's a Jesuit priest that I look to frequently for inspiration. And he says, very challengingly, actually, that not only is it important for us to recognize the importance of serving others, but to see that we need one another, that we belong to each other in the midst of our differences, and because of our differences, we have so much to learn from one another. And this is an intense time. This is a moment in which our country is powerfully divided in the midst of great environmental and racial strife. And it is challenging to look at those with whom we disagree and think that they belong to me and they are part and parcel of who I am as a child of God and have so much to share with me and to teach me. And that's really the challenge that I'm grappling with in this moment, one that I embrace, is that there is no other, there is no person truly different from myself, and that we are all united in the human community called to love and to serve one another as the Good Samaritan served us when we were on the side of the road. So have a wonderful day. Take care.
As we gather our prayers into one, we remember all those on the Notre Dame prayer list. We ask for God's grace for each of us to be the best versions of ourselves we can be. We ask for the courage of Mary, the first disciple, to live the prophetic nature of the gospel. For our whole community and for the intentions we all hold, we join together to pray the prayer that honors Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Have a great day, Notre Dame.
Sun's up, it's a little after 12. Make breakfast for myself. Leave the work for someone else.
Yes. Welcome back.
Oh, nothing can.
Welcome back.
Don't tell me.